What is going on, guys? It's Suk and I am back with a brand new video on Super Duper Tech. And with the 2016 MacBook Pro supporting only USB Type-C ports, I thought it would be a brilliant idea to showcase what I believe are the top 5 USB Type-C hard drives. And I will be basing these off the price, the capacity, as well as the performance. So without any further ado, let's hit the tiles. So to start off, the first hard drive that I did pick was the LaCie 5TB Porsche Design USB-C desktop hard drive. And currently through Apple's website, you can purchase this hard drive for £164. And one of the major selling points for this hard drive is that when you do connect it to your MacBook Pro, as well as transferring data, it will also allow you to charge the MacBook. So the first performance test that I did conduct was a file transfer of a 1.9GB file from the desktop to the hard drive itself, which took approximately 20.3 seconds. The next test that I did conduct was to take the same file and then copy it back over to the desktop. And once again, this transfer took approximately 20.38 seconds. Next, I did conduct a disk speed test, which gave me a write speed of 89.9 and a read speed of 88.7. Next up, I did conduct the exact same test, but using Aja Systems test, which gave me a write speed of 85 and a read of around 87. The next hard drive that I did use was a portable hard drive from LaCie with a capacity of 2TB. And this hard drive is currently on sale for around £160. As you've seen in the previous little test that I just did, I will be using the same 1.9GB file, transferring it to and from the hard drive and the desktop. And both times when transferring the file to the hard drive and from the hard drive, took approximately 14.4 seconds. Next up, I did want to do a disk speed test, which gave me a write speed of 128.4 and a read speed of 128.2. So once again, I did conduct another disk speed, this time using Aja Systems test. And for both the read and the write speeds, I got 125 megabits per second. Next up, I did test an external SSD from G Technology, which has a capacity of 500 gigabytes and is currently priced at almost £160. And once again, transferring the same 1.9GB file from the desktop to the SSD itself in real time took 5.23 seconds. And then transferring the same 1.9GB file from the 500GB SSD to the desktop took approximately 3.8 seconds. And conducting a disk speed test on this SSD gives us a write speed of 300 megabytes per second and a read of around 511. Once again, to ensure that the results were reliable, I did run Aja Systems test, which gave me a write speed of 317 and a read speed of around 500 megabytes per second. The next hard drive is once again from G Technology, which has a capacity of 1TB and is priced at £75. And once again, transferring the same file to the hard drive itself took approximately 15.3 seconds, while transferring the same file over to the desktop took approximately 12.9. And in terms of read and write speed performance, I was getting around 119 megabytes per second write, as well as 147 on the read. Using the Aja Systems test, I was getting around 126 megabytes per second on the write, as well as 146 for the read. And the last hard drive, which is once again from LaCie, which has a capacity of 1TB and currently costs around £82. As you've seen previously, transferring the same 1.9GB file from the desktop to the hard drive and then from the hard drive to the desktop both took around 14.2 seconds. Using the Blackmagic disk speed test, I was able to get a write speed of around 131 megabytes per second and a read of around 134 megabytes per second. And using the Aja Systems test, I was getting a read and write speed of around 131 megabytes per second. Now, I thought I'd throw this in just as a little bonus. Now, this is from SanDisk, has a capacity of 64 gigabytes and currently costs around £52. And transferring over the same 1.9GB file did take approximately 28 seconds. Now, if you do compare this to the 500GB SSD I showed you guys earlier, this is approximately 5 times as slower. But when transferring the file back over to the desktop, it took approximately 20 seconds. And once again, using the Blackmagic disk speed test, I was getting a write speed of 68 megabytes per second and a read of around 90. And using the Edge systems test, I was getting comparable results with 65 megabytes per second on the write as well as 90 on the read. So in my eyes, I do believe that the LaCie P9227 lineup of hard drives are perhaps the best in terms of price to capacity and performance. And this is made even more apparent when you do increase the capacity up to 4 terabytes, you do see that the price does remain to be very competitive when compared to others in the field. So guys, that has been it for today's video. If you did enjoy it, then make sure you hit that like button. And if you are new around here, then why not subscribe? Also, if you have got any questions or queries as to what you've seen in today's video, then go ahead and leave them down below in the comment section, or go ahead and hit me up on my social media. Once again, thank you guys very much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Have a good one.